Hello everyone, welcome to the latest episode of Sales Unboxing. If you'd like to know what games or collector's editions I'll be unboxing next, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell button. It's been quite some time since I've last unboxed anything video games with you, and I could already hear viewers complaining, "Hey, I thought you started with unboxing video game stuff. Have you stopped gaming or something?" One thing I'll never give up on is gaming. Is one of the ways I de-stress after a hard day work. The other thing? Modeling. As you can see from my model review videos. And I've just got this in the mail today, even though I'm actually 4 days late from the official release date. But nonetheless, as long as it's a good game, it's worth unboxing. This is what we'll be unboxing this week. Tekken 8 on PlayStation 5, with this version exclusively on Best Buy. But first, let's talk briefly about the Tekken series. The Tekken series has been one of the greatest and longest running fighting game series in both arcades and on home consoles. Ever since it started the very first Tekken in 1994, it has already released 8 numbered direct sequels, including this one, as well as 8 spin-off games, including the Tekken Tag Tournament, Street Fighter Cross Tekken, Pokken Tournament, etc. Not to mention live-action movies and Netflix animated series. With a franchise that runs for 30 years with no sign of slowing down, you can expect it will just get even stronger for the years to come. Tekken is also praised as one of the first fighting games to use 3D animation. For those who are into fighting games for quite some time, another full 3D fighting game that comes to mind would be Sega's Virtua Fighter that started their journey even 1 year earlier than Tekken. But Virtual Fighter stopped short with their 5th entry and no further installment was announced for quite some time. You may think that the direct opponents for Tekken series should be Street Fighter, The King of Fighters, Killer Instinct, Mortal Kombat, Dead or Alive, or the like. But their real threat at that time was truly Virtual Fighter. They even had an ad at that time with the main protagonists of the two games facing off each other, with Akira from Virtua Fighter saying, "You're 10 years too early," and Jin from Tekken saying, "You're 1 year too late." People at that time were speculating a crossover between the two franchises, as they both featured 3D animations and fighting. That, unfortunately, didn't happen, although they did release a Tekken 7 collaboration pack on Virtua Fighter 5 Ultimate Showdown with character costumes, background, music tracks, etc. from Tekken 7. Well, consider that as their crossover at long last. So, back to our main focus. With the death of Heihachi in Tekken 7, the tragic story between the Mishima and Kazuma families continues in Tekken 8 with the full return of the King of the Iron Fist tournament. The usual setup of the left and right hand and leg buttons are back like in previous iterations, but of course, they've added some new mechanics to help even novice players turn the tide with the new hit system. Tekken 8 is also the first in the franchise to utilize Unreal Engine 5 to create more realistic characters and stages. I participated in their beta testing and also played their demo before the actual game release, and I have to say, I'm impressed at how they present the game to fighters to the next level. Now, let's check the game itself. The version I got is the standard edition with some bonus from Best Buy. We'll talk about some other additions in a bit. Let me quickly remove the shrink wrap for a look. Just give me a moment. So here we go. We have the regular translucent blue PlayStation 5 plastic case with the slipcover featuring Jin and his father Kazuha. They truly have some family issues, much like the Skywalkers. You can see that Bandai Namco takes a more serious approach on their fighting game franchise with darker theme. On the back, we have some screenshots of the gameplay and descriptions. They keep the wording to the minimal since we don't need much to say about the game itself. Actions always speak louder than words, especially in fighting games. Let me just open the case to check what's inside. We have the game disc itself, and that's it. No other DLC cards inside or other goodies. But don't get disappointed just yet. Like I said earlier, this is the Best Buy exclusive version, and they do include something in here. They have thrown in an exclusive metal plate with the game. So you saw me struggle, right? It has the game title and the two glowing links of a chain that form number 8. I know it's nothing compared to a steelbook case or some of the collectibles, but at least it's a nice keepsake item. And if you pre-ordered from GameStop, you'll get a pair of magnetic fight glove keyring. Again, at least individual stores have their own exclusive items. Of course, Bandai Namco have their own premium collector's edition, but only exclusive on their web store in North America, like many of their own games. Now, hear me out. It includes the base game on disc, an electrified Jin figurine measuring 25 cm, a special face-off steelbook case, 8 glossy collectible cards, a Leroy Smith metal ring with velvet pouch, and an arcade token. It also includes digital DLC contents like the year 1 pass of playable characters, character costumes, and avatar costumes and skins. However, this premium collector's edition will set you back $299.99 US, and with the jaw-dropping shipping cost these days, it'll be way over $400 Canadian by the time I could even receive it. So unfortunately, I'm unable to get one and unbox that with you. However, if you happen to live in Asia, you're in luck, since game shops there may carry this edition without paying the extra shipping fee. So if you're a true collector, it may be something that you'll want to add to your collection. So that's it for this episode of Sales Unboxing. If you enjoyed this unboxing video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and leave your comments below. January and February this year will be very busy months, with a few fighting games and RPGs coming out within weeks. That's why I have great hesitations on which ones to get and unbox with you. So don't forget to stay tuned to see if the next unboxing will surprise you. Now it's time to dust off our fighting stick and hone our skills. Let the King of the Iron Fist tournament begin.